I, Dan Marinick, Chair of the Board of Governors of Sir Sanford Fleming College, declare this 2020 convocation officially open.
Hi everyone, I'm Drew Van Perries, Vice President of Economic and Community Development at Fleming College. I'd like to welcome everyone to our special virtual convocation ceremony for the Fleming College Class of 2020. Of course, we'd rather be doing this with having our graduates and our families and friends gathering at our beautiful campuses in Peterborough, Lindsay, and Halliburton. But of course, that's not possible. But we have created a virtual presentation for you today that'll follow the traditional program of our convocation ceremonies. You, our class of 2020, will always have a special place in the history of the college. You'll be forever recognized for succeeding during COVID-19, and you'll be called upon to reinvent and reimagine a lot of the traditional thinking as you go out into our workplaces. On behalf of all of the employees at Fleming, we would like to congratulate our graduates. We recognize the efforts you've gone to and the challenges you've overcome, and we know that you and your family and friends and your fellow alumni will make us all incredibly proud. I would like to respectfully acknowledge that Fleming College sits on the traditional lands of the Mississaugi, Anishinaabe, and Mississauga peoples. We offer our gratitude to our First Nations for their care of our earth and our relations. To open our ceremony, I would like to introduce Ashley Safar and Mary McLeod Beaver, who will offer a reading from our Indigenous Student Services team. They will also introduce the Indigenous Honor Song.
Ani Bojo Sego Nagamoe Mayenga Nidishnikas. My name is Ashley Safar, and I am the Manager of Indigenous Student Services.
Ani Bojo Nimkinap Koagin Indishnikas Alderil First Nation and Donjiba. Hello everybody, my name is Mary, and I'm the Indigenous Student Transitions Advisor for Fleming College.
For those of you who may not be aware, it is within our teachings that as settlers and our visitors to this territory, we must first introduce ourselves in order to share who we are, where we come from, and our intentions for being here today.
In the past, Fleming graduates have had the opportunity to show their declaration to Indigenous rights at convocation. This year, we'll be sending a link to your Fleming email and posting the link on our social media pages for an opportunity to sign the declaration to Indigenous rights. By signing this declaration, you'll be committing to acknowledging the rights of Indigenous peoples and being a respectful ally to First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples, both in your personal and professional lives.
On behalf of Fleming College, we would like to say Chimigwech to those of you who choose to sign the declaration and thereby taking an active role in the work towards reconciliation.
On behalf of Fleming Indigenous Student Services and Fleming's Indigenous Education Council, we would like to congratulate all Fleming graduates and wish you the best on your journeys.
We would also like to introduce you to Nimki Ozwamik. Nimki is Odawa and Potawatomi from Wukwemekong Unceded Territory on Manitoulin Island, and he's a member of the Wolf Clan. Nimki will be offering an honor song to our graduates.
Hey, hi, 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 hi
Thank you for that greeting and wonderful song. I would like to next introduce Dan Marinig, the chair of the Sir Sanford Fleming College Board of Governors, who will bring greetings on behalf of the board. And Dan will be followed by our president, Maureen Adamson, with a special message for the class of 2020.
My name is Dan Marinig, and I'm very happy to be celebrating all of your tremendous accomplishments today in our new format. I would like to extend my most sincere congratulations to all. You have made it through a unique year, one that presented many challenges. You are here, you have a Fleming diploma or certificate, which is what you need to embark on your new beginning. Today is cause for celebration and recognition. Celebrate all that you've achieved and recognize the role that you will play to rebuild our economy and support our community. Your hard work and dedication will be rewarded. Thank you for allowing Fleming College to be part of your educational journey. We look forward to seeing you grow and prosper in the years to come. Congratulations.
Hello, and welcome to your friends and family and all of those who are able to sign in and celebrate with you for this, the most unique convocation in our collective history, Convocation 2020. I want to acknowledge that this is not the preferred method of celebration for any of us. Students most definitely, but faculty and staff are also disappointed. And having experienced many days of in-person celebration last year, I too will miss the chance to see the smiles and the relief on the faces of students, the pride of their families, and the dedicated sense of satisfaction of our faculty and staff. It is family, it's friends, it's partners, it's neighbors, it's community. Those have made dreams come true today. Because let's face it, you did not do this alone. Everyone in your lives have had a part to play. But today, it is you, the graduate, who we honor. Fleming students have tenacity and are resilient. It is you, along with faculty, who pivoted on the head of a pin to make it all work when the entire world was in crises. A crisis that has never been experienced before in our history or in the history of our family and friends. It is your agility, these soft skills, that are exactly what our economy is seeking. Your social skills are what has kept Ontario and Canada largely safe during a global pandemic. Today, we're applauding the many accomplishments of our 2020 graduating classes. And this is a full circle moment for me. I was sitting in a large room waiting to cross the stage to receive my business diploma at Fleming College many years ago. Fleming was only the beginning. That led to a commerce degree, a master's in business, and now I'm well along the way in my PhD. So right here at Fleming, that's where that all began, and this is your beginning to many, many great things. Today, we're celebrating each of you as graduates of Fleming College who are prepared to enter high-demand careers that make up our thriving economy. Every one of you have come to Fleming through your own journey, your own desires, and your own tenacity. However you got here, the only thing that matters is that you did. And the only other thing that matters is the connections, the friends, the experiences that you had and will continue to have along the way. Of course, the fact that you are a college grad from one of Ontario's finest colleges is pretty cool as well. Last year, during convocation, I talked about the technological and societal change that was occurring. This year, I do not know where to begin. But the good news is that we are in no way at the beginning. We are all in. As a Fleming grad, it is you who have become that innovative and creative community builder that will lead and guide our new normal. You have become that social leader who will not stand for racism and intolerance and will not accept a world of standing by, because bystanding is part of the problem. It is not part of the action that is needed. And it is you who will apply your skills and knowledge that you have acquired at Fleming and will continue to acquire to hold the world accountable with respect and kindness. As a graduate of Trades and Technology, you will help put our community back together and get construction happening again at the right pace. You'll lead small entrepreneurial businesses that are the fabric of Ontario, and you'll continue to provide the skills that are immediate and everyday real. As a culinary grad, you'll find new ways to feed the world and save our environment. You will teach us to enjoy the best that Ontario local food offers, and you will be very popular every time you go home to cook for your parents who have cooked for you for an eternity. Now, more important than ever, the world needs you. Canada needs you. Ontario needs you. As you go out there, and let's face it, you already have, and it really isn't that scary at all. You will make mistakes, we all do. But remember, some of the most important sectors are built on mistakes, like research, applied research, drug commercialization, vaccines, and other life-changing remedies. Mistake after mistake leads to solution after solution. Fleming has equipped you with all that you need to create those solutions throughout your entire career. And Fleming is always here. We always have our hand on your back, and we always have your success in our hearts. Congratulations.
Next up, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce our 2020 Alumnus of Distinction. Phil Hurd is a distinguished business executive and a trailblazer in international events and economic development in Vancouver. His business acumen in operations, community betterment, marketing, and government relations has made him an influential leader across Canada. Career highlights include championing multi-million dollar mergers in the horse racing industry, managing the Molson Indy car race that attracted 160,000 people to Vancouver, developing a remarkable 2010 Olympic business program, and annually producing the Vancouver International Auto Show that featured worldwide automotive brands. And please join me in welcoming Phil Hurd.
Greetings, alumni. My name is Phil Hurd, and it is my privilege to be part of this graduation celebration for the class of 2020. On behalf of Fleming College Alumni Relations, I would like to welcome you as the newest members of Fleming Alumni Network of nearly 80,000 graduates living and working around the world, enhancing the vitality of our communities. The college has changed over the last 50 years. My college education taught me how to think, be prepared, be flexible, and the ability to accept challenges and changes as they arise. I hope it did that for you. The alumni network that you and I are now part of is more than just a group of people who graduated from Fleming College over the past 53 years. We are what Fleming College instills in us as students. We dare to dream. We continuously expand our knowledge and skills. We develop ourselves along with others. We create learning communities. We are innovative, and we build a better future. As you pursue your career aspirations, I encourage you to maintain the relationships you developed during what most alumni say are the most impactful, rewarding, memorable years of their lives. In the coming weeks, you will receive a Fleming alumni pin. When life gets busy, it will be your little reminder to stay connected and to remember the good times at Fleming. Class of 2020, you have worked hard to depart Fleming by completing your studies in a very challenging year. But remember that Fleming is not leaving you. The college is now rooted in you, and as Fleming alumni, your connection lasts forever. Congratulations, graduates. Today marks the day that you continue on your journey with all that Fleming gave you to become a very best version of yourself. Cheers to your success.
Thank you, Phil. On behalf of all alumni, congratulations once again to the class of 2020. You have now joined a growing network of nearly 80,000 Fleming College graduates. Stay informed by following Alumni Relations on social media and visiting the Fleming College alumni webpage. Stay connected. Networking is one of your most powerful career development tools. So make sure your alumni record is current by updating it through our website or through our alumni office. And we invite you to volunteer, join us at events, and take advantage of the perks and discounts we have specifically secured for our graduates. We know you'll be a remarkable ambassador for Fleming College as you move forward in your lives and careers. It is my privilege to announce the winner of the Governor General of Canada Award. The special award of a collegiate bronze medal is awarded to the student who achieves the highest overall grade point average from a diploma level program. This year's winner is Cassandra Trotter of the School of Business. Shelley York, our accounting program coordinator, describes Cassandra as a quiet and unassuming leader who is exceptionally determined to master any topic. She's not just satisfied with getting good grades, but truly understanding the how and why of everything. Cassandra is taking advantage of her pathway to a CPA designation and will be continuing her studies this fall at Trent University. Congratulations, Cassandra, on this remarkable achievement. We are incredibly proud of you and wish you continued success as you work towards your CPA designation. Next, I'm very honored to introduce our valedictorians for 2020. Our valedictorians are chosen not only on the basis of their academic achievement, but also on their overall contribution to the student experience at Fleming, inside the classroom and outside the classroom, including their contributions to our communities. Being a valedictorian is an honor that our graduates will carry with them the rest of their lives. Our valedictorian for the School of Trades and Technology is Jeffrey Moore.
Trades and technology grads, congratulations. It's been a few years since you started realizing your dreams with Fleming College, and we should all be proud of what we accomplished. But obviously, we couldn't have done this without the support of the college and of our unyielding instructors and our loving families. I personally felt really inspired by my fellow students who spent countless hours trying again and again to complete assignments that were almost certainly impossible. But that passion to do the impossible, to find a way no matter what, that's the passion that shapes your future, and you have to use it every day. This isn't the end of working hard. It's just the beginning. But we didn't get into this field because we like to take it easy, right? I think really there's two motivations behind the folks graduating today. The first one, and I get it, it's money, right? Big money? And if that's what you came here for, then you've done it. There's no shortage of well-paying work waiting for you. Heck, many of you probably won't even be here for convocation because you've already found a lucrative position. And for those of us who picked a field that involves sitting behind a desk all day, well, even better, since we get to work from the comfort of our own homes for the next year while the world burns down around us. Which brings us to the other motivator for doing all this, fixing things. I think that even those of us who came here for the sweet paycheck still feel a sense of pride when we make something better, right? I mean, I've loved fixing things since I was a child, so much so that I regularly broke things just to get a chance to fix them, including very expensive and important things like, you know, my mom's work computer. Sorry, Mom. But, you know, sometimes you have to break something to make it better. I think we all understand that. And that understanding is more important now than ever before, considering how happily the world seems to be tearing itself apart. It's tempting just to keep your head down in all of this and just say, thank God it's not me. But, you know, it is you and me and everybody. And we need more now than ever to go beyond just studying for our certifications and fixing the infrastructure we get paid to fix. We need to take time to learn about the people that we work with, and we need to apply the same courage and the same righteous indignation that we use to keep the technology of our world good, to keep the people of our world good. It's not easy, it's never going to be easy, but, you know, if anyone knows how to find a way no matter what, if anyone knows how to do the impossible against all odds, it's us, right? And we didn't want to take it easy anyways. So, again, congratulations! You made it to the end. Now, let's get started.
I would like to next call on our registrar, Ronnie Serdick, for the formal conferral of diplomas and certificates.
Madam President, it is my privilege to report to you that the candidates listed in this ceremony have qualified in all respects for diplomas or certificates by successfully completing the curriculum offered by Sir Sanford Fleming College. The faculty have recommended that they be awarded diplomas or certificates in recognition of their academic accomplishments.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Governors of Sir Sanford Fleming College, I do hereby confer on your respective diploma or certificate with all the honors, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Class of 2020, congratulations. You did it. You're now a graduate of Fleming College. You've had a year filled with adversity and you have come through it with such resilience. We know that you will go out into the world and do amazing things, and we can't wait to hear from you and about you. Congratulations. You've made us very proud.
Congratulations, graduates. You've finished out a challenging semester and you're off to a wonderful future. Wishing you all the best.
Today, we celebrate all your accomplishments. With that being said, moving forward, I'm challenging you to have a positive impact in your own community and in the industry that we love and cherish. Take care and keep in touch.
Congratulations on all your hard work. Graduation is not the end, it's definitely the beginning. I'm so proud of all of you. Thank you.
I am so incredibly proud of all of you. It's been a pleasure to get to know you. May the road rise with you. Congratulations.
Congratulations to class of 2020. I wish you all happiness and joy in the next step of your life.
Congrats, Fleming 2020 grads.
Congratulations to all the graduates. Your hard work and perseverance has paid off, and now you're a college graduate. That's awesome. I wish you guys all the best.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
And now, I'd like to formally present the graduating class of 2020 with special recognition of our award winners and those students who have earned the Indigenous Perspectives designation.
I'm on top of the world, hey. I'm on top of the world, hey. Waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. we walk the line and try to see.
We've now come to the end of Convocation, but before we close, I would like to once again acknowledge the hard work and tremendous efforts of each and every one of our graduates who have made it here today. And I would like to once again thank and congratulate our valedictorians and our award winners. Thank you for your invaluable contributions to Fleming College. You are all at an amazing place to be in your life. I also want to thank and acknowledge a few people involved in today's convocation. Dan Marinig, Chair of the Board of Governors, Ashley Safar and Mary McLeod Beaver for your Indigenous tribute to our graduates, to the staff in the Registrar's Office and our marketing team, as well as those around the college who have assisted with this event and throughout the year and in challenging times. And finally, thank you to all of our Fleming faculty and staff who have done a spectacular job in teaching and supporting students throughout some of the most trying times in 2020. And as I conclude, I'd like to impart a few words. Never forget who helped you along the way and who you will help. Your education is an important part of your arsenal, but never forget the relationships that you're developing along the way and sustaining. And graduates, always remember, you do you. Congratulations. It's my duty to announce the convocation is officially closed.